In their ruddy jackets of leather that reached to their knees, the men of Earl appeared before their lord. He leaned in his carven chair and heard their spokesman. For 700 years, the chiefs of your race have ruled us well, and yet the generations stream away, and there is no new thing. What would you, said the lord? We would be ruled by a magic lord, they said.
Grant us what we need, it is our right of you. Alberic, your son, must go in spite of you. There come here in wondrous ways to venture into timeless days, beyond the fields we know and into everlasting. The king of Elfland's daughter is a woman grown, told of by the songs that our fairy winds have blow on. She will bear a magic son. Alberic must be the one to bring her here and give us all the magic love. So be it. Our Lord has spoken. Only the dark ones know all that magic brings. So be it. Our choice is foolish. The Parliament of Hell knows only earthly things. That's why I said so be it. The answer to our Lord has agreed. Turn your face towards the light that beats from Fairyland.
So the old lord summoned his son, Alberic, and said to him, go from here eastwards and pass the fields we know till you see the lands that clearly pertain to Faerie, and cross their boundary, which is made of twilight, and come to that palace that is only told of in song. It is far from here, said the young man, Alberic. Yes, answered he, it is far. What do you bid me do, said the son, when I come to that palace? And his father said, to wed the king of Elfland's daughter. Her name is Lirazel. She is a princess of the magic line.
Music from the wind and trees and breezes through the moss and grass. At last the dawn should soon begin in Elfland. Buttercups that hide in shade have kissed the blade of grass they passed. The toadstool feels a fool, he has his hat on. Prancing, prancing, foolish dancing trolls decide to run and hide. Play to turn about and twist and shout, hand in hand the trolls resist.
Near the castle of Earl, there lived a lonely witch on the high land near the thunder, which used to roll in summer along the hills. There she dwelt by herself in a narrow cottage of thatch and roamed the high fields alone to gather the thunderbolts. Thunderbolts that had no earthly forging, that made such weapons as had to parry unearthly dangers.
All among the lonely heath, the little children cry. Witch, high on a broomstick, riding through the sky. All around the bar at night, when owls and bats do fly. Witch, spinning a spell, there's thunder in the sky. Earth, fire, and wind, and water, dew of morning, clouds of May, scent of thyme, and sight of lilac, thunderbolt iron will win the day. Earth, fire, and wind, and water, dew of morning, clouds of May, scent of thyme, and sight of lilac, thunderbolt iron will win the day. Thunderbolt iron will win the day. All along behind the houses, creeping through the dark. Witch, bringing the shadows, how the dogs do bark. All around the fire at night, the sparks and ashes fly. Witch, taking a blade, there's thunder.
So it was that Alberic, after travelling towards the Elfin Mountains, pushed through a hedge into a field untended, and there, suddenly, close before him, was the frontier of twilight. It stretched across the field in front of him, blue and dense like water. He looked back once over the fields we know, but nothing seemed to answer or heed his farewells, and so he strode on boldly into those long masses of twilight.
Bright as the sun, blue as the night, nothing stirring, my eyes are blinded by the light. Still I travel on, I was never born to kill, but if I must, I will, I dare not fail. And the task is laid on me, now far as damp and dark. Draw the sword, raise it high. Now is not the time to die. Draw the sword, wield it well. Now is not the time to fail. spire on spire, higher and higher, like blue sapphire, and it's loose. Through mortals twine, she seems to glide, and I can neither breathe nor move. With crowns of ice and wandering eyes, she turns and sighs, who are you? Mortal man, from earth I am, from fields and lands, you do not know. Crystal doors are open wide, gods are rushing, now the sword is in my hand. Weaving, flashing, there's blood upon the blade, and their bodies fill the glade. At my side I hear a voice, we must leave now, for there is no choice. As we run, I can hear a father's footsteps ringing clear. Filled with rage, he climbed his tower, gathering his deadly power. Dull and gray with earthly light, the elfin border comes in sight. Hang on through the mist together, soon we will be safe forever.
So Lirazel looked upon the fields we know, and Alveric watched her bringing a beauty to our fields more delicate even than the wild roses brought, and he saw that her crown of ice had melted away. On the high balcony of his gleaming tower, the king of Elfland stood. He knew well the harshness of material things and all the turmoil of time. And he knew that there hung over his daughter now the doom of all mortal things. And then he wept, and all Elfland shivered.
Silence be on all Elfland. Troubled am I, your king. Lirazel is far from Elfland, perishing like an earthly thing. Before you, time surrounds her spirit, as time decays the earthly flowers. Why should my daughter be taken by pitiless years? This time is passing, never ceasing. Time will take its toll too soon. Bring me plume and bring me parchment. I will write a mighty rune. Send for a drum.
when she was with me. Time to think and time to dream. Soon the rune will travel earthward. Once again she'll stand by me. Where is the troll? Summon the god! Where's the parchment? We shall see who calls the tune. Now fetch the troll.
I'm running, a message I bring to shout or sing, jump and spin. I'm humming like a top. I never stop, whirling, twirling round. Look at me, it's plain to see, the world is in my hand. I am free, I am free. I'm so free, nothing can stop me. I'm as wild as the wind. As a feather, quick as the wind, like a bird on the wing. I'm flying, faster than lightning, never a sound over the ground. I'm flying, like a top. I never stop, whirling, twirling round. Look at me, it's plain to see, the world is in my hand. I am free, I am free. I'm so free, nothing can stop me. I'm as wild as the wind. I can laugh, I can sing, but you can't catch me. I am free, I am free.
Into the castle of Earl jumped the troll, and bowing low before Lirazel, he presented the elf king's rune. No sooner had she read the rune than fancies from Elfland began to pour over the border. Little queer sounds of elfin creatures came to her. Scents swam from those miraculous flowers that glowed by the lawns she knew. All Elfland was calling. She rose at once, and now Earth had lost on her the grip that it only has on material things. There passed 10 years over the fields we know while Alvaric searched for Lirazel. And all the while the king of Elfland watched, for he knew by magic when Alvaric's sword drew near. It had troubled his kingdom once, and he knew well the flavor of thunderbolt iron when he felt it loom on the air. From this he had withdrawn his frontiers far, leaving a space that to cross would weary the comet. But when Alvaric was far to the north, the elf king loosened his grip, and Elfland came racing back. Tide over flat sands.
Masters of poetry know how to say it may be a wise man, knows what it means. Judas, they say, is the man to betray. Love is the word, but the meaning is feeling the love. Love I feel for her. Love is a friend when your love is beside you. But love shows no mercy when you're all alone. Love is a princess from Elfland. Love is the word, but the meaning is feeling the love I feel for her. Just another day of searching.
Up and down. Will tomorrow bring me sorrow? Will it bring me just another day of searching? Up and down. Will tomorrow bring me sorrow? Will it bring me just another day of searching?
It's only my own heart that yearns for my princess. The love, it is mine, and the feeling is mine in a word. And the word, it is love. Just another day of searching.
Up and down. Will tomorrow bring me sorrow? Will it bring me just another day of searching? Up and down. Will tomorrow bring me sorrow?
Are in the lumber loft, the trolls are in the stable, goblins hiding under the bed while we hide under the table. Faces at the window, horrible flickering lights, and things that chase us down the road if we go out at night.
Magic, magic everywhere. Magic in the very air. Elfin horns are blowing. There is too much magic. We dare not go or wander in, for fear of what the night may bring. A curse upon all elvish things. Too much magic.
Many a creature of fable, many a monster of myth, crept through the elfin border to see the will of the wisp. And every time we go to bed, we pray the Lord will keep us from the dark unearthly things as we lie in our sleep.
Magic, magic, everything.
I saw a goblin crouching there, I wish he'd go away. Down the streets of tile and thatch, the fairy army creeps. We sowed the seeds of discontent, and discontent we reap.
Magic, magic everywhere, magic.
In the hall that was built of moonlight, dreams, music, and mirage, Lirazel knelt before her father's throne and besought a rune that should restore to her Alberic, bringing him over the border and into the elfin lands. And with him, she prayed might come some garden of earth, or bank where violets lay, or hollow where cowslips swayed, to shine Elfland forever. I have no rune, he said, that has power to lure anything from the mundane fields. No rune, but one. And that, the last of the potencies of our realm. And so it was that those in Earl saw coming towards them a shimmering line of silver sweeping over the fields. Slowly it came, like the blended twilights of old, lost summer evenings. It flowed past the houses and broke over them with a burst of unearthly foam. Elf land had poured over.